In this screencast, we're going to define some crystal systems and then give an example of a ceramic crystal structure. So there are seven basic crystal systems. And what these depend on are what are known as lattice constants. And the lattice constants are A, B, C. In this case, this is A, this is B, and this is C. So there are these lengths. In addition, we look at the interaxial angles, and we define these as alpha, beta, and gamma. And these are these angles right here. Changing our lattice constants and or our interaxial angles will change the type of system. So here we have what's known as a tetragonal or tetragonal or however you want to pronounce it. And in here, A equals B, but does not equal C. So this is an elongated type of structure. However, all the angles are the same and equal 90 degrees. We compare that with our cubic structure up here, where A equals B equals C, and alpha equals beta equals gamma equals 90 degrees, and this should be a gamma. So each system can have more than one unit cell. So for example, a cubic system can have three types of unit cells: simple, face-centered cubic, and body-centered cubic. The tetragonal system has two unit cells. If you look at all seven basic crystal systems and add up the number of unit cells within each one, what you find is you end up with 14 Bravais standard unit cells. And these can describe all possible lattice networks. So we're going to look at a more complicated structure, and those are known as ceramic. So these ceramic crystal structures are identified by the following constraints. First of all, they have to have at least two elements. Second, if they are ionic, they consist of cations and anions. The crystal has to be neutral, and as we know, cations, because they lose an electron or more than one, are less than the anions. Therefore, the ratio of the radius of the cation to that of the anion has to be less than one. And what this ratio does is it describes the coordination number, which are the number of atoms that one atom can touch. And they want to touch as many of each other as they can. So we have different types of ceramic structures. And the most basic one is what's known as the AX structure. So an example of that is sodium chloride. There's one anion for each cation. In addition, we can have a system such as AMXP, such that M and or P do not equal 1. Thus, an example of this would be something like calcium fluoride. We also have a system that is a little bit more complex. A M, B, N, X, P. And let's show an example of that right here. This is what's known as the perovskite crystal structure. And an example here has a barium, titanium, O3. So first, let's check that it is neutral. So barium has a +2, titanium is +4, and oxygen is -2. So that's 2 + 4 + 3 times -2 for the oxygen, which equals 0. So it is neutral. So the structure for this is that we have one oxygen here on each face. We have a barium on each corner. And finally, we have one titanium in the middle. Let's make sure that this adds up to the relationship of barium to titanium to oxygen. If we look at one oxygen on each face has 1/2 an atom. There are 6 faces. So there are in our unit cell 3 atoms of oxygen. Now we look at the barium. Each corner is 1/8 of an atom. There are 8 corners. So there is 1 atom of barium. And finally, we have titanium, which is just 1 atom in the center. Therefore, we have barium, titanium, and 3 atoms of oxygen. So there are a number of different ceramic crystal geometries. What determines the type of geometry is, first of all, this ratio of the cation to the anion, and that leads to our coordination number, which then leads to the geometry. So for example, if you have a coordination number of 4, then you have one cation, for example, in the middle, and it's surrounded by 4 anions in a tetrahedral type of geometry.